other questions for Mo?
How do you think you played Mo? When you, did you get a chance to review the game yet?
Yeah. Okay, I started off great, where I wanted to start off. And then after that, I felt like I started tackling that. Felt like I was just going on and not of my expectations for myself and of my coaches. Started off good and started tackling that and then just did whatever it took at the end to secure the win.
How much confidence do you think you can take from the last few series, though, on defense, you know, getting those three stops at the end?
Last four. Meant a lot, you know. We had to give our offense the chance to execute and do what they did at the end, and we did it. So as a defense, that's all you ask for, one less point than the opponent to get that win.
What do you know about Northwestern? Did 1-3 in a row with Michigan State last week.
Yeah, I know they have a pretty good running back, Jackson, and Thorson, their quarterback, great runner. Make play, extend plays with his legs, the intermediate to long thrower. So he's a leader and the heart and soul of his team, and you can see that even just watching the first few series of film.
When you had a couple tough weeks as a team or a defense against Wisconsin, what was the key during those 2 weeks during the bye, and what Coach Diaco kind of, you know, get across to you guys during that time?
Just focusing on ourselves, you know, little things that makes you a better player or makes you a good player, you know, tackling, stuff like that, coverage, just the little stuff that we was lacking as the season went by, that we were real good when the season started and then started to lack a little bit. So just tuning up, that's what really made me kind of disappointed in the tackling for this game, because we worked on that and I was great in practice, and to come out there and start tackling that was unacceptable.
Everybody talked about Coach Yakov's energy during the off season, but does he have kind of a calm kind of approach when you're kind of in the middle of a game, or how would you describe him?
In the game?
Yeah, or I mean like at halftime and stuff.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He gives you confidence. You know, you come, you know, even that last drive before halftime, I was in there just shaking my head, and he just comes in there and he gives you confidence because he know what you can actually do. And that's what I felt like we gained, you know, after the half. And he came in there real calm and collective and told us what we need to do to fix the problems, and then we did it.
Would you like to have down on the field that didn't work for you?
No, I feel like Coach Brady does a great job in you know, leading us while he's on, while Coach Diaco is in the press box analyzing the offense and giving the right calls. I feel like Coach Brady does a great job in leading us out there. So.
Do you ever wonder what Coach Diaco's thinking, though, or like what he's going to say when he comes down to the locker room?
When I mess up in the play, I'm thinking, I don't want to see him right now. Just let him down. So, I know he feels great joy. He loves us. So when we make great plays, I can feel his energy from the press box. And just like someone you never want to disappoint when you make a bad play, you know, you feel that you let him down. So in that point, that's all.
What were you thinking on that last drive that Tanner led to the touchdown to win the game? Or did you think he could do it?
It was magical. You know, I felt like something would happen. Then you started making great decisions. And real great decisions, and our players, our offensive players, started making the great decisions too. Tyler Hoppus with the stiff arm going out of bounds, and players, running backs knowing where to go out of bounds, and the importance of going out of bounds, and just the chemistry with him and Stan for that last touchdown. That was, it clicked, and that's the quarterback I've seen in fall camp. So, you know, y'all just have to give him a chance. He's grown in his home, and he's going to be a great player for us.
Dedrick's playing with that cast on his hand. How tough would you imagine that is to try to play
on that? Even with these running backs we had to tackle, I know it was pretty tough for him. But, you know, he manned up. You know, he's my roommate, so he never doubted himself going into the game. And, you know, he just said, I got a cast, just got to do what I got man up and execute. And that's what he did to the best of his capability.
What are the challenges this week? You see Justin Jackson versus last week, you guys saw a 260-pound running back.
Justin Jackson, he runs like a 260-pound running back. He's real physical, high knees when he runs. Love to use the stiff arm, and you know, he plays with heart and passion. As a player, you admire us as a defense have to match that heart.
Is that the highest percentage of plays that you've played so far this year against Purdue?
Percentage of, I would say so.
You know, when you win a game the way you guys did, how does that affect how you guys prepare? What you guys look at this week now coming off that?
I mean, every game is four quarters long, so. You just look at it as you know, as every down, every play, you know, even after making a bad play, it's always, you always could redeem yourself. The game is not over, so that's what you could take after that game. You know, we redeemed ourselves, we had pride, and we stuck it out and won.
Any more questions, Mo?